To simulate and visualize how a space can be used, we'll place some handrails, furniture, fixtures, and site elements. These elements are stored under the Object tool in ARCHICAD. You may continue working on the current project, or open the TS03 Chapter 5 PLN ARCHICAD solo project file to complete this chapter of the training series. The ARCHICAD library has a wide range of objects, including furniture, sanitary fixtures, special building structures, site elements, and so on. To open the set of available library parts, select the Object tool in the toolbox and display the Object Default Settings dialog. On the left side, you can see a folder structure by default. The self-explanatory folder names help you find the needed part by type. However, you can also use the search field where you can find library parts by their names and tags. On the right side, you can see the parameters of the currently selected library parts. Objects are GDL elements. Their settings are very similar to what you've already seen for doors and windows. If you open a new project, the standard ARCHICAD library is loaded. You can check and manage loaded libraries in the Library Manager dialog. You can open the dialog using File, Libraries and Objects, Library Manager. This dialog contains all information about the loaded libraries and elements and their status. For example, if it lists a missing object that does not exist in the default ARCHICAD library, then we have to load it. Click on the Add button. Browse the extracted folder of this training guide and select the Training Textures folder. Click Choose, and then click the Reload and Apply button below. Click OK. The folder and its content is now added to the project. Objects created in the project are stored as embedded library parts automatically. For example, the StairMaker stair is now visible in the list as a result of our work earlier. Let's start the work by adding handrails. First, we will create railings for the terrace of the gallery. Open Gallery from the project map of the pop-up navigator or from the tab bar. Open the Object Settings dialog. Type railing in the search field. Select rail wired in the search results list. Display the preview and positioning panel of the dialog. Enter -0.15 for bottom offset to home story. Enter 90 degrees for the rotation angle. Select the bottom right insertion point on the plan view of the preview image. Make sure that the gallery is selected for home story. Display the rail settings panel of the dialog and select the style and dimensions panel. Enter 0.95 for the height of the railing and 0.20 for the distance from the slab or stair. Enter 1.20 for the horizontal length of the railing. Display the Categories and Properties panel. Select Non-Load-Bearing Element for Structural Function, Exterior for Position, and Railing for Element Classification. Select the Interior Furniture layer. Click OK to apply all changes. Zoom into the terrace slab above the entrance. Click the meeting point of the terrace slab and the exterior wall. Open the Rail Settings dialog and change the insertion point to bottom left on the preview image. Place another railing on the other open side of the terrace. The railing above the entrance is too short. Select it and click its mid-top hotspot to display the pet palette. Select the Move Node command to modify the length of the railing. Drag it to the intersection point with the stone wall. Open the 3D view to check the result. The posts of the shorter railing are too dense. Let's fix this. Select the railing in the 3D view and open its settings dialog. Display the rail settings panel and select the handrail and post page. Enter 2 for the number of posts. Click OK to apply this change.